Introduction. The average family exists only on paper, and its average budget is a fiction, invented by statisticians for the convenience of statisticians. Sylvia Porter. Unlike the quote provided above, seemingly reflective of general opinion on family budgets today, we will attempt to take a much more positive approach to budgeting as a family-oriented, user-friendly, financial management and planning tool and life enabler. However, when reflecting on family budgeting and inquiring as to why not more families are actually using it, it becomes self-evident that similar skepticism runs rampant and deep in reality and society, even globally so. Once you start probing family budgets, expending time and energy researching the subject in depth, it becomes quite clear that most families are caught in a vicious, almost never-ending cycle of what comes in must go out. Most families might feel that budgeting is a futile effort, unnecessarily burdening them with thoughts and ways to go broke methodically and slowly, without the creature comforts and indulgences of our human modern-day society. Others might voice that they feel as if they are merely throwing money away in a never-ending and dizzying spiral of spend, spend, spend. People are getting deeper and deeper into debt, no matter how hard they try to get out of it. Questions are then raised: how do we stop these courses of action? How do we change the thinking around family fiscal discipline? Put simply, in How to Set Up a Family Budget, we focus in on how to empower families to set up better, more realistic budgets, stick to them and celebrate their successes, and learn from their failures. Families eventually do have a monthly surplus, see their savings start to grow, consolidate their debt, set aside discretionary funds and personal allowances, build their wealth and become more aware of their proactive involvement and responsibility regarding their lives and finances. This is when excitement builds and fundamental thought patterns as well as spending attitudes are changed. Budgeting is seen as an accurate measurement of success when significant behavioral transformation is taking place on the landscape of the family budget, spending habits, and financial patterns we observe over time. Do you ever feel that you do not have enough cash at the end of the month to pay bills, buy necessities of life? Are you barely making a dent in your credit card debt balance, no matter how hard you try? Here is a reality check for all of us: if we choose to spend it, it is gone for good. We cannot spend it on anything else. Are you perhaps worried about a nest egg for your golden years or savings for early retirement? Then you have arrived at a source that can provide some prudent tips on how to start, finish, implement, stick to, revise, and refine a family budget. The family budget is a dynamic process, even more so than a mere static work product, result, process outcome, or document. It will, can, and should change over time. It becomes a barometer of a family's fiscal circumstance, resources, and health. Maybe budgeting is not as much about reflecting on what you cannot have, but more about thoughts on how to stretch, invest, and spend your earned dollars more wisely. In short, it is about making your money going further. This quick reference how-to guide was developed to assist you with setting up your own personal, household, and family budget, to help you with all of the above and more. A couple of general money savings will also be provided in these pages. There are also thoughts and spending patterns that need to change in order to become fiscally more disciplined, and many techniques, attitudes, habitual behaviors that we need to unearth, evaluate, and possibly change before you even start budgeting. For example, being a bargain hunter looking for good buys, cutting down on careless spending, being on the lookout for careless credit card spending, and letting the person who handles money best in your household actually take care of it, are all good examples of what we mean. For most households, a budget is no more than a spending plan. Any spending plan can help you see where your money is going. It fits your spending to your income. It reflects how we get the things we want and need most, while being ready and prepared for bills we must pay every month. For most families, it is simply about making a budget you can live with and stick to easily. It is not a difficult exercise, but one most people fear, avoid, or dread because of the unknown and perceived complexity of it, sometimes wrongfully so. Part of the goal of this guide is to demystify family budgeting and highlight an easy systematic process to setting up a quality family budget. Many things actually drive our expenditure. We choose to spend our money on things we value, need, prefer, or consciously choose. For some it is clothes, for others it might be something as simple as taking that yearly vacation. Whether you are making financial decisions for yourself or your household, you might have to make some serious choices and adjustments regarding your financial freedom and situation. How to Set Up a Family Budget is a quick reference, easy, how-to guide, meant to take you through the typical who, why, when, what, where and how questions typically asked when considering fiscal planning for the household and or budgeting in general for your family need, means, and circumstance, now and for the future. Budgeting is not just about restricting spending and living a cheapskate life. It is about insights, wisdom, informed decisions, action and sustained discipline when it comes to your household financials. This guide will invite you to learn more in these pages about systematic budgeting. It focuses on practical application and zooms in to apply these best practice suggestions in your own home. It empowers you to put together a dynamic, financial plan that suits your pocketbook, means and circumstance. Financially speaking, assess quickly where you think you and your family are today. What kind of a picture do you have? Could you come up with something? Did you have the data and numbers you needed? Would you be able to plan for where you want to be and start living your life today as a fiscally sound and disciplined family with the information you have at your disposal at present? Money makes the world go round. It is no secret that some of us have more, some have less. We deal with our own personal finances and cash management distinctly differently. Households have varying needs, means, and circumstance. Our money management skills are also at different levels, as is our debt and savings. Budgeting has to do with most of these perspectives and reflections. The purpose and goal of family budgeting is financial situational analysis and informed awareness. 2. Cutting cost. 3. Gaining control or curbing spending and 4. Starting to save, building up wealth and liquid assets over time. There are many phases and steps to go through when creating a budget. If you are looking for ways to manage your money better, making it reach and stretch further, and providing you with financial security and a more solid future, then you have come to the right place. In this brief introduction on family budgets, we have already introduced our first couple of key questions. Why an ebook or how-to guide on setting up a family budget? Why would or do you need a family budget? What is the business case for and rationale behind family budgeting? What are the benefits and advantages of a family budget? We elaborate a little more below. For most people, a family budget is the equivalent of a simplistic process: money is earned and comes in, money is spent and moves out. It is a fluid, easy flow, one-directional, cash management process. It is driven by daily life, a spending orientation, or no plan at all. For most families, income is also fixed and outflow typically increases over time, as the needs of the family fluctuates and changes. Loading up on debt is also very typical for the majority of our families. If this sounds very much like a vicious circle, it is. Most families are caught up in it and constantly battle to get out. Mostly, we think that we wisely spend our money on necessities like food and clothing, gas and household or family needs, but can rarely put a finger on where the money actually goes, let alone produce a budget. A good place to start is to monitor these expenses. Take stock of your fiscal situation. Start with assessing where exactly you are in your financial life and circumstance. Most of us think we know, but we really do not. That is, until we take the time to actually list, study, and analyze the situation. Figure out what your financial worth is, look at all financial goals, and set a timeline for reaching them. Does this sound like an action plan? Where do you start? A good suggestion is your bank statements, tax return and recent current credit report, a financial asset statement if you will, and an overview of the current situation. The premise is simple: you cannot get to arrive where you want to be if you do not know where you are today, what it will take to get where you need to be, and how to get there. A well-thought-out, planned and realistic budget will serve as a roadmap to get you there. It is a financial tool facilitating your financial dreams, goals and aspirations, making them become a reality. Budgeting will enable you to actually reach your financial targets and set goals. What is your current financial status? How do you define financial worth? Is it cash in the bank, savings and checking accounts, or RRSPs, stocks and investment portfolio? Remember, anything you have that is of value counts. All your assets form part of your financial picture and health. Ask yourself, what is your take-home pay, after deductions? How are you paid? Is it monthly, weekly, bi-weekly? Then you need to budget accordingly. Think about all other sources of income, temporary, seasonal, part-time extra income, found money and bonuses that you might have. Maybe deciding to leave it out of your family budget altogether is wise and advisable? We will delve into this question a little later. Try to find ways to do without some small creature comforts and pleasures to reap bigger rewards later. Starting small, early and now, with discipline and commitment, a steady, consistent pace and amount every month, tracking and optimizing financial phenomena like compound interest, which we will describe later, will all feed into this process. We will take this journey into budgeting together to see how it can change lives, yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Back to listing assets and thinking about savings, consider all banks, savings and loans, credit union accounts, money market accounts, certificates of deposit, Christmas club accounts you might have. All liquid assets that can be readily turned into cash need to be included. Consolidate accounts if you have too many accounts spread out and save on banking fees. Improve tracking actual spending better and more easily. Earn higher interest and have less exposure to identity theft or fraud by getting a good handle on your current situation. For most individuals and families alike, this step is quite a revelation. It forms the basis and baseline for deeper analysis and scrutiny. Other assets might include things like art, precious metals, sculptures, paintings, collections, antiques, jewelry, and more. Most of us are used to having a short-term focus on money and budgeting. A paradigm shift is required to move us towards a more in-depth, longer-range view and planning. Set short, mid- and long-term goals, have a definite structured plan, read up on family budgeting, personal financials, and fiscal management strategies. All of this will help us focus on what is important for our needs, requirements, and circumstance, while keeping financial discipline and budgeting in the forefront of our busy lives. This is never an easy task amidst all the hustle and bustle that is our daily lives. Most of the published literature on family budgeting in general centers around how to get out of debt, stay out of debt, and live a full and prosperous life. Some suggest frugal living is the answer and offer your money or your life perspectives, where you cannot necessarily have both. There are many examples advocating the cheapskate monthly makeover that focuses on shaving costs off expenses and living frugally. Market providers, both online and offline, offer various budget kits which offers worksheets and more, and there is always the handy tip like Kohl's Notes and the Pocket Idiot's Guide to Living on a Budget. Other sources focus on becoming totally debt-free, debt-proofing your life, getting a life and choosing simplicity, or how to address credit card debt and expenditure. This how-to guide is a little different. We have chosen to take a very hands-on, practical approach to fiscal management and get you started, walking through the budgeting steps and set you up, sending you off, well and good, on course to solid budgeting in your family and household. This brings us to the who, what, when, where, why and how part of the discussion. These form the dynamic, interacting and interdependent elements, systems and processes that form family budgeting. Who? Every family situation is uniquely different and distinctive. There is no one-size-fits-all answer and solution for everyone. Some of the tips in this guide might apply to your unique means and circumstance, and others may not have any significant impact or practical application at all. In general terms, you will find handy ideas, hints, process steps, practical savings suggestions and budgeting that might have gone unnoticed before. The information provided is general and should be evaluated on an individual and contextualized basis. Remember to consult a financial advisor when making fiscal decisions that could affect the financial health, well-being, and future of you and your treasured family. There are various different families in question here too: single income, single parent, blended and/or extended families, double income households, stay-at-home mothers working part-time from the home to make ends meet, social supported and/or subsidized families, families at risk, divorced household with shared parenting and financial responsibilities, debt-ridden or bankruptcy families, and numerous others. We hope to offer something for everyone. What? Family budgeting is a structured process and planning activity, dealing with a family's financial resources and context. This hands-on approach puts expense items into categories as another helpful strategy. This is done to get a better handle on the current situation and offers somewhat of a reality check to most that choose to undertake this journey. Some of the categories could be: obligations, list each item under headings like home, mortgage or rent, association fees and professional dues, insurance, health, auto, home, renters and life, tuition, daycare, loans, car loan, student loan, bank fees and interest, taxes, property taxes, and so on. Necessities, again list each item under headings like food, groceries, gas, yard maintenance, security, pest control, utilities, gas, water, electric, garbage, sewer, school lunches, household supplies, car maintenance, monthly parking, housekeeper, household repairs, internet service, dry cleaning, cable TV, and more. Pocket expenses, treat this as a whole category, covering lunch at work, snacks, sodas, coffee, drinks, parking, tolls, newspapers, magazines, batteries, postage, shipping, mail. Family allowances, another whole category including items like parties, entertainment, weekend outing, movies, concerts, other entertainment and events, home improvements and decorating, magazine and other subscriptions, dining out and fast food, furniture. Personal allowances, clothing, hobbies, personal recreation, books, CDs, manicures, hair, alterations, shoe repair, personal gifts, luggage, night out with friends, gardening, films, processing, video rentals, sports/recreation, family gifts, contributions, donations, computer software and other related items. When and where? In the interest of brevity, we combine the next two facets. Our best assessment to answering when and where the best place and time would be to start a family budget would be to answer unequivocally, here and now. It demands attention as it directly affects our daily lives and well-being. Without delay, hesitation, or postponement, we need to step up and protect our family interest, financial health, and future. Accounting brings accountability. A wealth management guru is often quoted as saying, "This rings so true." It is hard to ignore if we are confronted with objective cold hard financial facts that tell us that we are in trouble. Why budget? Families, as mentioned before, have diverse reasons and motivations for budgeting. Briefly summarized, people budget for a couple of reasons. To gain control of their financial life, monthly bills, and spending. Be prepared and avoid surprises. Save for a major purchase. Opt out of a vicious circle of ever-spiraling debt or spend now, pay later thinking. Expand their lifestyles. Retire early. Eliminate money as a source of tension and topic for argument. Rediscover that the best things in life are free. Becoming self-reliant and empowered to know that debt does not rule their lives anymore. We promise even more on this a little later. Family budgets defined. How to budget. Some general strategies are helpful in assisting families to set up a budget or budget better. The first significant step is to change your thinking about money, shift your attitude towards spending, actually focus on saving money, planning ahead and driving for success. Develop a greater awareness of how you earn, manage, save, and spend money. Awareness of how others would lure, entice and want you to spend your money, advertisers, retailers, and manufacturers. To stop participating and playing the keeping up with the Joneses game, living with a false sense of wealth and security, while overextending yourself and financial resources, beyond your means. Do not envy others and lust after things that they might have, or even worse, get deeper into debt to compete or keep up appearances. It is counterproductive and can ruin lives. Delay purchases, learn and do, sometimes without having to buy. Set solid financial and budget goals for yourself and your family that you can work on individually and collectively to achieve together. Set spending limits and stick to them. Do not make ends meet utilizing credit cards, stay away from ATM machines, cash, cash advances, do not cheat on your budget. Understand your income, know where the money is coming from and how it varies throughout a one-year cycle. Understand your expenses, monthly and irregular, unexpected expenses. Set a few realistic financial goals. Know your own habits, spending, temptation, and where the areas of risk and exposure are. Set up savings and spending mechanisms that work, reserve and growth accounts, and have the right number of credit cards. Make an income plan, detail is important. Plan your obligations and must-pays, smooth out large-size bills with reserve accounts. Plan your necessities and look for ways to economize. Set aside pocket money for daily incidentals. Create a family allowance to cover entertainment. Create a personal allowance. Balance and consolidate, wise decisions and trade-offs, agree and stick to it. Live happily on a budget. Welcome to frugal living mode. Cutting back on living expenses, alternatives for simple living. Re-examine why you work and how you live. Stop tossing your hard-earned cash away. Shopping, overwork, stress and debt, some refer to this as an illness-quipped affluenza. Celebrate when you have money left over at the end of the month, indulge a little and reward yourself, rewarding patience and persistence. Not just the doing good and sticking with it. How to set up a family budget is advocating a new code of fiscal honor for our families, so to speak. It proposes family budgets that ask for wisdom, best choices and decisions, discipline, sticking to it, honesty, no cheating, persistence and celebration when we do it right. The rationale and process of budgeting. Here are 12 good reasons to get you started. 1. Family budgets are used as a baseline, analysis tool and roadmap. It is a useful tool and guide. It tells you whether you are headed in the direction you want to be headed in financially. It helps you to move from spending to saving and good fiscal balance, management, and responsibility. You may have goals and dreams, but if you do not set up guidelines for reaching them and you do not measure your progress, you may end up going so far in the wrong direction you can never make it back. Can you imagine the government or a major corporation operating without a budget? No, and neither should you. 2. It is often described and justified as an empowering enabler. A budget lets you control your money instead of your money controlling you. 3. A budget is a realistic estimate and true reflection of current circumstance and means, a type of financial situation analysis that will tell you if you are living within your means. Before the widespread use of credit cards, you could tell if you were living within your means because you had money left over after paying all your bills. There are lots of family budgeting tools available online that make it a fun and enjoyable task and activity to assess and analyze your family's financial situation with minimum effort. **www.moneypants.com. There is also lots of free financial software and most of it sets up easily and provides you with a detailed family budget online. It manages your finances, hassle-free and almost effortless. Well, almost. It will require input and minimum effort through hands-on involvement in setting it up, populating, maintaining and editing it. **velopes.com is a good example of market offerings that are available at no cost to you, just waiting for the motivated family budgeter to embrace and try it out. Some websites offer free financial newsletters by email, with lots of money-saving tips, budget advice, and other relevant personal and family-related financial information, **www.planabudget.com. The availability, accessibility, virtual marketplace, ease of use and more of credit cards has made the need for family budgets much less obvious. Many people do not even realize they are living far beyond their means until they are knee-deep in debt, struggling to make ends meet and sinking fast into murky financial waters. Budgeting is and can be a life and money saver, a reality check, but also a remedy. 4. A budget can help you meet your savings goals. It includes a mechanism for setting aside money for savings and investments. 5. Following a realistic budget frees up spare cash so you can use your money on the things that really matter to you instead of frittering it away on things you do not even remember buying. 6. A budget helps your entire family focus on common goals. It is unifying families in mutual purpose and effort, working together towards a successful outcome and reward. 7. A budget helps you prepare for emergencies or large or unanticipated expenses that might otherwise knock you for a loop financially. 8. A budget can improve your marriage. A good budget is not just a spending plan, it is a communication tool. Done right, a budget can bring the two of you closer together as you identify and work towards common goals and reduce arguments about money. 9. A budget reveals areas where you are spending too much money, so you can refocus on your most important goals. 10. A budget can keep you out of debt or help you get out of debt. 11. A budget actually creates extra money for you to do use on things that matter to you. 12. A budget helps you sleep better at night because you do not lie awake worrying about how you are going to make ends meet. Nevertheless, despite all these wonderful reasons quoted above, people are still hesitant to commit to family budgeting as standard practice in their households. We might again want to probe a little deeper still and ask why. Top 3 causes of budget failure. Many people make an honest attempt to budget, but become discouraged and give up before they are able to accomplish any significant financial gain. The top 3 causes of budget failure come into play before you even begin to set up your budget. Awareness of these budget busters is your first line of defense in the battle of the budget. Budget buster number 1, negative attitude. It cannot be emphasized enough, a positive attitude about budgeting is essential to your success. If you think of budgeting in negative terms, such as a financial diet, financial handcuffs, restrictive, penny-pinching, a sacrifice, etc., you are sure to fail, unless you are a martyr or a masochist who finds some strange reward in a punishing experience. For purposes of this article, we will assume that you are neither. A positive attitude means you think of a budget as a means to an end, a way to achieve your dreams and goals, and that postponing the instant gratification of spending all the money you earn is worth the rewards you will earn in the end. Budget buster number 2, lack of motivation. What is your motivation for budgeting? Are you trying to appease a nagging spouse? Following the terms of a debt repayment plan with a consumer credit counseling agency? Complying with an agreement made in bankruptcy court? These are not bad motivations, but they are external pressures and will probably not be easy to maintain over time. The best motivations are internally generated. Do you honestly believe that budgeting can help you meet your goals? If you need a little help in the motivation department, see 12 Reasons Budgeting Can Improve Your Life. A quick reread of these will surely inspire and ignite a motivational spark or two. Budget buster number 3, unrealistic expectations. What do you expect to gain from instituting and following a budget? Do you think that setting up a budget will reveal large caches of hidden cash, or that the budget fairy will sprinkle fairy dust over your budget and magically transform your spending habits after a month or two of tracking expenses? The reality is that budgeting is an endurance event. Those who stick with it, through thick and thin, will come out ahead financially. Do not expect miracles. What you will see if you stick with it is steady, measurable progress towards the goals that really matter to you. Starting a budget without having a positive attitude, internal motivation, and realistic expectations will probably set you up for failure. You can greatly increase your chances of success by ruling out the 3 biggest budget busters before you even begin. Family budgeting, just the thought of it makes most of us cringe. However, mostly, we do attempt to curb our spending and live within our means. Others fall into bad habits, habitual spending patterns, or impulse shopping and overextend themselves, landing knee-deep in debt. Ironically, one of the first remedies for any debt consolidation or repair strategy is to take a long, hard look at the budget and financial patterns within the household. It is almost like running a diagnostic. To take a closer look, you are in effect placing your family dollars under a magnifying glass and microscope. This can prove both challenging and painful for most people. We hope to alleviate some of that initial discomfort and apprehension with this handy step-by-step guide and tips. Most financial advisors will tell you that you have to reward yourself for good fiscal responsibility, discipline, and habits to increase your motivation and success levels. Budgeting is the first step, sticking with and to it a close second, and the sometimes overlooked but ever-important reward has to keep the motivation going. To repeat and continue to experience the benefit of the budgeting cycle and discipline could be an uphill battle, but there are calmer seas ahead. Cash management, savings, planning for retirement, setting financial goals, etc., active and hands-on, is becoming increasingly important for the survival and well-being of our families everywhere. Be your own best expert with coming up with new ideas on how to save money, budget better, and spend less. Your unique strategies stem from a deep understanding of your own situation, demands, and needs. Discover which tips and ideas work best for you. After all, fiscal management and finances are definitely not a one-size-fits-all solution environment. It is personal, customized, and unique. In the following section, we will briefly refer back to the family budget defined and look at some of its elements and criteria, purpose, and functions. What is a family budget? What constitutes a good family budget? What should it contain and look like? What is the family budget again? It is a proactive, hands-on approach, focused, technical, and disciplined strategy to getting a handle on the current financial situation in the home and family. It concerns setting realistic, smart financial goals for the household, sticking to it, celebrating successes, learning from failures, and trying again if you do not succeed or get it right the first time round. It is about shifting focus completely from a mainly spending to a savings orientation. Cash and Money Management 101 for Everyone. We have laid out what a family budget is, does, and affects. A brief mention of what constitutes as good family budget and the elements that it contains, as well as its appearance, format, and functional role follows. All of us have a wish list of new things that we want. There is always things we would find in places to spend our money. Take the time to make a list of these things. Let everyone who shares cost in your home to have input into making and finalizing this list. Write down what you want most. Beside the goal, write how much it will cost. Split it into goals with ongoing costs and the cost per month, and goals with a one-time cost, and list the actual total cost, including all hidden fees, taxes, shipping, and/or other charges that might apply. Now, next to these columns, start to prioritize these goals. Which goal comes first? You need to decide which goal on your list should come first. Talk this over with the other members of your family. If you live alone, think it over yourself. Try to list your top four goals and decide what you can fit into your budget. A good budget is in the eyes of the creator or beholder alike. Some suggested, but by no means comprehensive criteria follows. Budget is both process and product. Collaborative, engaged, hands-on effort. Characterized by communication and mutual agreement. It advocates involvement and exchange. It is real-time and reality-based. Factual. Accurate. A financial checkup and check-in on the family finances, household dollars, situations, behaviors, and resources. An action plan, future-oriented. Offers a peek into the past, scrutinizes and enlightens the present, while planning and promising a future. Goal and results oriented. The family budget process. This brings us to the family budget process. We might ask questions like, how to set up a family budget? How should a family budget be used? Insights around the tools and techniques of family budgeting could also be useful. Practical suggestions for setting up a budget? A step-by-step summary of a family budget process. Hints, tips, tricks, and tools for setting up a family budget. Stay tuned for more. To get us started and in order to set up a monthly budget, follow these five easy steps. Step 1. Find out your monthly take-home pay. Step 2. Find out what your expenses are. Step 3. Find out how much you spend on each expense. Step 4. See if your monthly expenses match monthly take-home pay. Step 5. Balance your budget. This means in your family budget you need to ensure that you are spending matches take-home pay. It might indicate that you have to cut back on spending to balance. It sounds too good to be true and too simplistic. However, in the end, that is all there is to this family budgeting process. Initially at least. Let us look at these steps one at a time. Finding out your monthly take-home pay. Your income is your pay after some money is deducted. Think taxes, insurance, and Social Security. Answer the following questions. What is your monthly take-home pay? Do other people share expenses in your home? As mentioned before, total all of the household's monthly take-home pay. This will include all sources of income for all contributing members of the household. Finding out what your expenses are. This brings up other pressing questions. What are your monthly expenses? Where does the money in fact go every month? Most people are surprised to learn that it may go for things that we do not need at all. Writing your expenditures down provides us with the unique opportunity to visualize and find out if any money goes for things that we do not need or want. Here is a short list of expenses that many people have. Put a check mark next to ones you have, then write down any expenses you have that are not on the list. Necessities like food, clothes, laundry, dry cleaning, car and transportation expenses, gas, oil, parking, license, plates, car repair, train fare or bus fare. Rent, mortgage payments, heat, electricity, phone, water, property taxes, house repair, appliance and repair, furniture, small items for home, cleaning supplies on the yard care. Medical and dental expenses, doctor, dentist, drugs, hospital or clinic. Savings, short to medium term for something soon, a future purchase, emergencies, investments. Installment payments, car, furniture, appliances, charge accounts, credit card accounts, loans. Pocket money, personal allowances, tobacco, beer, wine, and hair care. Entertainment, movies and eating out, recreation, sports and equipment, club membership, newspaper, magazines, cable TV, records and tapes, DVDs, videos and other multimedia, vacation, letters and postage. School bills, books, room and board at school, workshops, special training courses, lessons, music and more. Donations, church or synagogue, charitable giving, charities, other and gifts. Insurance, if not deducted from your paycheck, life, health, house, car, and property. Taxes, if not deducted from your paycheck, federal, state, and local income, social security. Which other ones could you list? Finding out how much you actually spend on each expense. This is the hard part, where some thought and effort will have to go into the process to ensure the most accurate information is recorded. This will give a realistic and real-time estimate that is reliable and accurate. In this section, you need to ask yourself how much each item on your list actually costs, how much each item costs you a month. The following estimates and guidelines could prove helpful to you as you set up your family budget. Monthly bills that stay the same, car and rental payments. Monthly bills that change, utilities, phones and more. Fine costs per month for say 6 months, add them up. Take this number you have calculated and divide it by 6. The amount of months, to get your average cost. This is the number you will be using for your budgetary exercise. Bills that come every 3 or 6 months, the number for every month will be used in your budgetary process. Bills that come annually, meaning once a year, divide the amount by 12 months. The answer is your monthly budget number. Bills that come more than once a month, food, gas, lunch, and family fun. This is a category to watch very closely, as it is a contributor to this bottomless pit we sometimes feel and see our cash disappear into. Unexpected expenditures or surprise bills, what you can afford to set aside as a buffer or emergency contingency fund, look at the last 3 years or so and see what kind of unexpected expenses you and your family faced. Use an estimate that makes sense to you and divide the annual number by 12 months to get your monthly number. Finding out if monthly expenses match monthly take-home pay. Compare your total expenses with your take-home pay. A couple of results and scenarios could be staring you in the face. Positive result, income more than expense, you can either spend or save. Negative result, expense more than income, spending more than you have, you might have to cut costs and try to save some money to cover the bases. Whichever of these outcomes you are faced with, knowing is better than not knowing. For some, this might bring little comfort and relief, but people in general, find this exercise useful to make an unknown more measurable. It makes us both accountable and wanting to act faster, and that sense of urgency and momentum is just what the family budget process needs. Finding ways to balance your budget. Earlier it was stated that a good budget would mean income would be equal to expenses. Having a small surplus is no guarantee by any means. You might need this to cover an unexpected rise in oil and gas prices or a larger grocery bill due to a party you are hosting at home. This almost brings the concept home of a sliding scale, flexibility and discretionary buffer categories in budgets to absorb this give-and-take rollercoaster ride that is family budgeting. The good news is whether you are in the red, so to speak, or just scraping by, managing to save nothing or maybe a little, or even a lot, this process will highlight areas where your attention is needed right away. It gives direction and purpose and assists families to formulate their spending plans, goals, revisit their needs, dreams, and goals. Balancing the budget is no easy task. Here are a few steps that we can suggest to make your life a little easier. Find out how much you need to cut from your expenses. Decide you can make cuts in your expenses and be detailed. Rebalance your income and expenses after you've made these cuts. A word to the wise, do not make cuts in your budget that you cannot live with in real life. It is extremely important to remain realistic and keep your real-time expenses and living realities in the forefront of your mind when you make these decisions. If you're getting out of a situation where you are in debt and short of cash, you have to try to curb spending any way you can. Cutting those expenses are crucial, not only because you are over budget. We mean that there might be other reasons, like adding a budget line to your overall planning for your family vacation. Realistically, we cannot add and address new needs and goals before we have fulfilled our duty and responsibilities. Cutting a little here and there will mostly do the trick, cancel that newspaper subscription for the papers that just land in the recycle box or garbage anyway. Do you need all the specialty channels and packages on your cable TV options? Can you live with giving some up? There is always the specter of rising prices and interest rates, inflation and more to cope with as well, so building preparedness for that into your budget is also a priority. Whatever we can do to cut our costs and expenditure will benefit our pocketbooks and family budgets immensely. Cutting back on things you need the least is a good starting point if you are at a total loss as to what and how to give something up, add a new line into your budget or plan for the future or inevitabilities. You are well on your way in the family budgeting process. You are doing it, every step of the way. Consolidate and revisit your budget often. It is a dynamic process and living document or tool, so to speak, to help you keep your fingers on the pulse of your financial situation. Another useful strategy is to set up a bill-paying plan and process that will protect your interest. When, how, and how much you get paid will all influence your course of action. Creative and innovative allocation of your paycheck is the key. If you get paid once a month, the amounts in your budget will have to be paid monthly as is. If you get paid twice a month, divide each budget item by two. If paid bi-weekly, as is mostly the practice these days, still divide the monthly amount by two. It will not be the exact amount to plan for, but a rough and close estimate. In the end, better than nothing. If you are paid weekly, divide each budget item into four. Cash flow management will form a big part of your fiscal strategy once you have put your budget pen to paper and mapped out the needs and requirements. Utilize your cash, checking and savings account, if applicable, to pay for expenses. Do not pay your bills with your credit card. Keep track of all your discretionary spending. A financial diary for a week is always a good idea to scribble down, and every time you withdraw money, pay for something or open your purse without thinking. This will provide you with insights you did not have before on where the money actually goes. It will also carry within it clues to adjust budget lines if actual cost is higher on certain items. Spending patterns and behaviors will emerge that might surprise or shock you. Having some wriggle room and discretionary spending is always motivation. The occasional treat and indulgence, special night out or other family activity, is that more enjoyable if you know you have worked hard to earn it and deserve a pat on the back for all your fiscal responsibility and discipline. Always keep one eye on the future, folks. Budgets might need to change again and again for a variety of reasons. You can never feel you have arrived completely and that your budget is set in stone. Family and life often throws us a curveball or two, banks, service providers, government and fate sometimes do too. Changing budgets should not be a source of frustration for you. It actually shows you that your family budgeting process is actually working. It is a real-time pulse and mechanism to capture these changes, which will leave you prepared and informed, ready to act and respond appropriately. This impetus for change can come from different sources. Here are some examples. Change of income, goals, rising prices, goals reached, family growing, moving and or relocating to a new place, family getting smaller, new spending habits, change in lifestyle or unplanned expenses. If you can stick with it and see it through, a family budget can help you meet your goals, get and stay out of debt, pay your bills on time, every time, keep track of your spending, cut costs, and stretch your dollar to the max. Hints, tips, tools and tricks for setting up a family budget. Creating a budget captures in its expression and meaning both the excitement and the apprehension most of us feel when we have to face our financial situation and our lack of planning and accountability in that area. Most businesses would fail if they ran like we manage our household incomes sometimes. This is not a natural thing for people to want to do. It falls into that "I will if I really have no choice" kind of categories. However, worth mentioning is that we spend most of our waking hours at work, earning the cash we need to get by and cover our living expenses. Then, we do not take the time to plan what to do with it. We just respond, spend and move on, spiraling, circling around, aimlessly and oblivious mostly about the state of our financial affairs. This is obviously not true for some of us, for whom planning and organizing comes naturally and budgeting is like second nature and breathing. We just do not think about it, get it done and then barely spare it a second thought. Both these types of approaches can hurt us in the long run. Our society has also become so fast-paced and focused on success that we sometimes lose sight of the future perspective, enjoying life and what we do have. We cannot really focus on our own financials for lots of excuses, sorry reasons we provide like trouble slowing down, taking a step back and evaluating our financial situations, or not knowing how to set up a family budget. One of the first hints or tips we provide is advocating fiscal awareness. This means evaluating openly, freely, and honestly where things are at today for your finances and household. The whole purpose and goal of creating or setting up a family budget is to enlighten and alleviate money pressures. Utilizing a tool that can assist you in getting back onto the road to financial freedom, fiscal responsibility, and financial, budgetary health, positive cash flow, with money to spare would be the ideal work tool to grasp and grab. As the previous pages have shown, the process in itself is not altogether that difficult. You can certainly see how this real-time, dollar and expenditure tracker can assist you to be agile and respond to market, family and monetary pressure, changes and crises. Continue to revise and update your budget as your needs, family and circumstances change. Money is such a daily necessity and ever-present in our comings and goings. There is no escaping it. It is everywhere and needed anywhere and all over. We have different currencies, structures, procedures and all around the world, but in the end, it is the currency that makes the world go round, fueling the global economy. Seen from that perspective, we often feel that taking control of our own finances and expenditures will not have much of an impact, as we are all at the mercy of the wheels and gear of a churning economical machine, with government and banking rules, regulations, trade and principles, ethics and decision-making that affects our quality of life. However, this is simply not the case. Good money management skills in the household is crucial, not only for survival and good financial state of affairs, it teaches our children how we think handling money should be taken care of. They watch us so closely. We model certain behaviors, spending patterns, discipline, or maybe throwing all caution to the wind with credit card spending, debt and reminder notices all over the house, creditors calling, afraid to walk to the mailbox to remove the bills, and more. What chance do our children have to end up entangled in that spiraling and vicious circle we spoke about earlier? Money in, money out? How do we get to the point where family budgeting is a learning tool to help us teach our kids to work better with their funds? Whether through allowances, mutual savings goals, their own account or more, as parents we have an opportunity to instill some solid financial skills early on in life that will assist them later, as they work toward their independence and family budgets of their own. Do some of your own soul searching before you start your budgeting process. How motivated are you to plan, set up and stick to a family budget? Would you do it now? Today? If you knew how? Then let us get started, together. There are lots of practical suggestions for setting up a family or household budget. We will never be able to cover them or the mechanics and intricacies all here at once. You will, however, continue to find in these pages valuable insights and tidbits to help you pursue better fiscal management and cash flow, budgeting in general. It is all about making your dollar go further. Investing in the time and effort that it will take to get to that point of greater financial security and possibly even have a surplus eventually. 1. Take stock and face the facts head-on, honestly and with serious commitment, drive, and purpose. Assessing your own capital worth and analyzing your home life and situation from a financial perspective is of utmost importance. 2. Plot your own course. Formulate some financial goals and lay out your own roadmap on how to get where you need and want to be financially speaking. 3. Take a thorough, critical, and factual look at your fiscal situation and status. Unbiased and honest is best. Get a most recent credit report and look over your bank and credit card statements, tax returns, and other financial sources of information, stock portfolio, RRSPs, and more. Get a financial planner to assist you if you are unsure about what to use and include or not in this assessment. You might also want to take a broader perspective and discuss retirement, priorities, insurance needs, will and testament and more, because, like financials, we never seem to take these crucial life planning tasks and to do very seriously and barely give them second thought or time of day. The time is now and the place is here to take control of your financial situation and life. For committing the time and effort to build your financial action and spending plan, budget and goals should get priority and might just be the most valuable undertaking and time well spent, not wasted you might ever set aside. 5. Think of how you define your own financial worth. Reflect on what it is, what you base it on. Is it concrete data and fact, perception, or maybe even a wild guess or estimate? Income, savings, and all of your other assets work together to give you the whole fiscal picture. This side of the balance sheet for most people remains fixed and is relatively easy to do when they put their minds to it. 6. Always remember that this process and document known as a family budget is only going to be as good as the data and updates you provide. When acquiring new assets, ensure that this side of the balance sheet is strengthened appropriately. 7. Adjust your focus slightly to more in-depth and longer term. We live so much in the moment, especially if we purchase things or spend our money. We just look at the cost today and do not think of interest over time, and this being the total cost, of course. 8. Actually setting financial goals will also energize you, give you a reason to work towards something meaningful. You might even start to enjoy uncovering opportunities for frugal choices, penny pinching, and what we prefer to call creative savings techniques. 9. Become financially literate and master the family budget process, tools and worksheets, spending logs. Demystify some of the complexities and just try some fiscal responsibilities, without being overwhelmed by the intricacies of calculations and more. Remember, there is always professional help out there, once you have gotten started, completed the grunt and groundwork to move in and on to a comprehensive consultation with a personal, professional financial planner, who can explain the lay of the land, impact of your situation and plan in more detail. Most of them will offer the first consultation free to assess your situation for you. Most of them utilize state-of-the-art software and technology industry-related and customized tools that shed light on even the darkest situation, to find a little ray of hope and a couple of dollars at the end of the tunnel. There is a way out of the abyss. 10. Family budgeting can be used to teach you good fiscal habits. Get in the habit of paying in cash, using your credit cards only for emergencies. Learn how to stop buying on impulse and use your willpower to walk away, say no thank you, and leave it at that. Shop at wholesale and discount department stores. Respect your budget limits and stick to it. Buy generic medicine and support your discount pharmacy. Always try to find ways to supplement your income, part-time jobs, your own business or rent a room or floor in your house, offer storage, invest in real estate and take in a boarder or tenant. Turn your thermostat way down in your house and turn off a few lights. Winterize your house from top to bottom. Eliminate and treat areas where heat and energy is lost. Cut back on home and cell phone use. Check insurance policies, shop around and raise your deductible to lower your monthly bill. In isolation, these probably do not have a lot of impact individually, but when they are combining in a well-planned, cleverly executed family budget, with discipline and consistency, they will start to make a difference and you will start to see the benefits and impact on your bottom line. 11. A family budget is a learning tool and process to empower individuals and families to better self-manage their financial resources, spending, cost-cutting, and household finances. In general, you will be able to set up your own personal or family budget. By tackling the skill and mastery of smart budgeting, you will have a greater understanding eventually of exactly where and by how much you need to adjust expenses to either live within your means or know how much extra you need to maintain your current lifestyle.